Come on, she's coming back with me. Come on, get going, you lot.
Thanks a lot, love.
Look after yourselves.
Lizzie!
I'll be all right, honest.
Oh, God, you will.
Oh, come on, you two.
Bye, Doreen.
Bye.
Come on, good luck, love. Bye.
Come on, Dor.
Think you're doing? Why aren't you inside?
It's a funeral.
What?
Now, poor soul, she's dead and gone. And she got what she deserved. She murdered my Megan and now I've buried her.
That's enough of that.
What's dead is dead.
I'll have to do better than that to convince a jury. You're no more crazy than the rest of them. Now, get a move on. Hey, guard! Wake up! You're supposed to make sure no one leaves the marquee. I've just found this woman wandering around out here. You're a security guard. Behave like one. No one's allowed to go anywhere near the fence.
Someone will have got themselves out of here. I'm going to take the torch with me.
you think you'd be able to find the opening?
Don't worry, I'll find it. Won't be long. Just back up. Chin up. At least we're not all buried under that lot.
What a mess. Lucky I came down with that. Well, if I hadn't come down, you would have been left here in the dark all on your own. Yeah. Maybe you are the fairy godmother after all, Lizzie.
Forever.
Well, don't worry, she'll turn up.
Well, bloody kill that, Lizzie. She'll be right, just look normal.
Oh, yeah, a normal prince.
G'day, prince. Charming little woman you got there. Be a Lizzie.
I don't know.
I'm better things up.
No, they won't. Bea knows what she's doing. Hey, we ought to be singing Here Comes the Bride. You know that one? Hey, sing along with this one. Having a ball. Look at it.
They shouldn't even be here. This is a prison.
Could have fooled me. Today, anyway. Hey, how about another round of knick-knack paddywhack? Hey!
Now, you get the children outside the gate as quickly as you can, please. Get the women inside. There's been an escape. Excuse me, please.
Now you know how the miners feel when they get stuck down underground. Remember that TV thing we saw? When the roof caved in and they're all sitting around singing and...
We'll change the subject, Lizzie.
Oh, yeah, of course. You made a great Cinderella door. You know, you could have been a TV star if you'd really wanted to. And the little kids, they just loved you.
You didn't do so bad yourself, Lizzie. You got most of the cheers.
You reckon?
Yeah. The fairy godmother was the favourite, no worries.
Yeah?
Thank you. Yeah. He's taking the time. She'll be a while yet. Old Vinegar Tits will have to put her gumboots on before she'd ever come down here.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
Funny, isn't it? Me and me, we weren't gonna come down here. I thought about it and then I thought, well, what's the point? Here I am. Is that you, B?
Yeah.
Oh, what happened?
I found the manhole cover. I couldn't move the bastard.
What do you mean?
I mean it's stuck. And we're stuck down here.
And what are we gonna do?
I don't know.
We'll have to think of something fast.
I looked at some of the other tunnels. They didn't seem to lead anywhere, though. I was worried about going too far in case I couldn't get back here.
Yeah, well, we've got to do something. We can't just sit here.
Yeah, don't worry. Someone will work out something's happened to us, and we'll just have to sit and wait.
How are they going to work out that we're stuck down here? Yeah, the others won't lag. They'll think we got out. And Judy and Mouse, well, they'll think we've gone back up. And no one's going to know we're down here.
Now, come on, calm down. No, it's not as bad as you think. When I came down here, I told Anne to tell Margo to let us out when we came back. As far as I can work out, the top's got stuck somehow. But don't worry, Margo will figure out that something's happened to us and she'll tell the screws.
You told Anne?
Yeah.
Oh, babe. I wouldn't have trusted her. She's as mad as a bloody meat axe.
Oh, come on. She's not as mad as all that. She'll tell Margo. A matter of time.
I told you, didn't I?
Have a look at you. You look shocking, love. Right, okay, make that smooth. How do I look, huh?
You wouldn't make the front cover of Vogue. There's dirt in your hair. I'll get it out. Shoulders.
All right, miss. Thank you very much. That's a big chance, huh? Mouse out of a drain pipe, right? Oh. Come on, just take a look.
Right.
They have a full roll call in the morning, but at the moment it looks like Nagel, Smith and Birdsworth have gone over the wire.
Why aren't these women in cells?
They're on their way now. Burns? Burns, where are you going?
Oh, it's Hunt.
Where's Burns?
I don't know. Costumes off, everyone.
In front of him.
All right, into your cells.
Kent, you can add Trapp and Burns to that list. That makes five. And Bryant.
Six have gone. This place is a disaster. I want the cell of every escaped prisoner searched for anything that'll give a clue to their intentions. The police will be here by now. We'd better get back.
Go on.
Quiet, you lot. You're in enough trouble as it is.
Now, you take those ridiculous costumes off. That includes you, Gaffney.
Aren't I charming enough for you, Vera?
That's enough. Get in there.
You search Smith's cell. I'll go through Brian's.
Right.
I see. Good. Thank you.
Well?
Detective Inspector Bridges is in charge.
Good. He knows how to deal with prisoners on the run.
Tracker dogs have been dispatched, and teams of police are already combing the area.
What really irks me is that this prison is so incompetent that six fairly ordinary women can simply climb over the wire and disappear without any of your officers lifting a finger.
Are you suggesting the officers let them go? I consider my officers do an extremely good job.
Today's episode hardly confirms that. Anything?
There's nothing in Smith's cell. Mr. Fletcher's searching the others.
Miss Bennett, how do you explain this escape?
I can't, but someone must have seen them.
You didn't notice any of them missing during the charade?
Well, I was aware that Smith and Birdsworth didn't appear to be involved in the business afterwards. I went looking for them.
You didn't alert anyone?
I wasn't sure.
But you couldn't see them?
No, but one of the prisoners had told...
Prisoners don't run this prison.
No, sir.
Why wasn't the alarm sounded at once? What the hell do you officers think your job involves? Babysitting? Precious minutes were lost because you, Miss Bennett, weren't sure. Perhaps the difference between an unsuccessful attempt and a successful breakout. Just how much do you value your job, Miss Bennett? I want every officer on duty questioned as to why nobody saw the escape. The security arrangements for this event were well laid. I considered the level of surveillance was strong. What I didn't bargain on was the incompetence of your staff. It's a miracle every prisoner in the place hasn't walked out the front gate years ago.
I found this in Bryant's cell.
We acknowledge that we have to serve our time, and while the prison was no paradise before, we managed. Since, however, Gestapo methods have been introduced by Gillespie, we can stand it no longer. This one's on you, Mr. G. Not rubbish.
May I see that?
That doesn't get us very far. What I wanted was evidence of their intentions.
I didn't see anything else.
It would seem this escape was a premeditated act against what they considered to be impossible repression.
The security measures I introduced were vital to patch up the holes in the existing system. I don't have to defend them. They speak for themselves.
Six women over the wire.
Because they were allowed to cavort before a lot of kids dressed in non-prison clothes. Something I was against from the very beginning.
Oh, that's the point, though, isn't it? I mean, that'd still be in pantomime costume. That should be easy to spot. Two ugly sisters, a Cinderella and a fairy godmother on the run.
I'm surprised to find it so amusing, Fletcher. But they won't get far. And when they do return, this prison's going to be the tightest-run penal institution in the state. I was sent here to do a job, and by hell, I'm going to do it.
Doing. I didn't know it was yours, did I?
And what difference does that make? Let's just see what you've got here. Oh, it's a nice little hole for pocket money, isn't it?
Well, you shouldn't leave it lying about, should you? You might lose it.
Funny boy.
Well, what'll we do with him?
We take him to the police. What
the
do you think?
Police? But they'll
I
be
think they'd be very interested in what we have here, don't you?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Hey, look, lady, I'm sorry I pinched your stuff, all right, but if I'd known you was a wrestler, I wouldn't have touched it.
Are you thinking of turning me in for assault?
Oh, come on, Jude, let's go.
All right. Now, come, sister.
Thanks, lady. See ya.
Where do you think you're going? Now, you go in the back and get some rope or something like that and get the keys while you're there.
Okay.
Hey, how'd you like to come for a Sunday drive, eh? Oh, brother. Now, let's see what we got here, honey. Sandra Bates, how's that grab you?
It's better than Heather Trapp if the cops don't catch me.
Well, that's who you're going to be from now on, Sandra Bates.
Who are you going to be?
Audrey Turner. I think it suits me, don't you, little Audrey?
Hardly.
Yeah, well, we won't need these two. Come on, love. Let's go.
Right, well, we'll have detailed descriptions out based on these. I doubt if we'll have too much trouble.
I'm afraid you must bear in mind that four have previous experience of escape.
I'm surprised you didn't bear that in mind. Still, we'll be onto them. Oh, one thing that puzzles me, though, there are no tracks that the dogs can pick up in the area where you say the ladder was.
No scent at all?
Nothing, no. If there were tire marks or something, I could assume that they'd been picked up, but there's nothing. Is there any other way they could have gone?
It's pretty impossible, I'd say. The security's been fairly thorough. Armed perimeter guards, roof guards, officers in the grounds and so on. No. I'd say it has to be over the wire.
Well, is there any internal information available?
Mrs. Davidson doesn't believe the prisoners will talk, but I believe, given a little incentive, we could well get something.
We have found in the past the prisoners are unlikely to inform on escapees.
Perhaps you haven't tried hard enough. I assume we'll be taking remission off all the prisoners involved in the pantomime. Quite a chunk of it would be my recommendation. Then we offer a private deal for any information. That should do the trick. I've found in my long experience in prisons that when freedom comes a little closer, They jump for it.
Sounds good to me.
I can't agree. You won't get information that way. They stick together.
We'll see, won't we?
Up to the bars!
Hey, Mr. Fletcher, what's happening? Hey! Hey, Mrs. Dick! Hey.
Up to the bars!
Hey, Mr. Fletcher, it's tea time! Hey.
Quiet, you lot! The governor wants a word with you! Quiet!
You are, of course, expecting to be punished for today's escapades. For six women to have escaped, there must have been extensive planning. Therefore, I hold you all responsible. Every prisoner who was involved in the pantomime will lose 1 month's remission.
Silence! Silence, or I'll pick a few more candidates for solitary.
However, should any of you decide you have something to tell us, I will make an exception.
Any informer will, of course, be treated in confidence. But in the meantime, you'll all be locked in your cells until further notice. And if any officer receives any more complaints or disrespectful comments, the offenders will be severely dealt with.
Glad I haven't kept you waiting. You've obviously been tied up.
Hey, where are we?
We're halfway there.
To where?
To where we're going.
Well, what are you going to do to me?
We'll find out.
But you can't leave me out here.
You want to bet?
But you can't.
Now, you listen to me, son. You got a choice, you know that? You can stay here, or we can take you to the nearest police station and drop you off. Now, what is it?
You bitch.
Oh, thank you. And goodbye.
From here.
Well, I reckon we ought to get as far away from the city as possible, so a couple of hundred miles further into the country and then we can split.
Split up?
Yeah, well, that was the idea, wasn't it?
What'll I do?
I don't know what you'll do, darling. You're a free woman now.
I don't know anyone in the country. I've lived in the city all my life.
Well, it'll be a nice change for you, won't it? Now, you've gone this far. Why don't you just go the whole way and start afresh somewhere? Remember Jackie Nolan? She did.
I'd prefer to stay with you till we settle down, you know.
No, we can't do that. We'll be seen together. It'll be too obvious.
I can't do it.
Oh, you'll have to do it.
All my friends are in the city. Who the hell do I know out here?
All
nobody.
Right, all right. We'll stay together, huh?
Oh, thanks, Jude.
Can't move it.
I don't understand why the bloody thing's blocked.
I reckon that Ann done it.
You're probably right. Well, she's the only one that could have. I told her we'd be back soon. I told her we wouldn't be long.
How long do you reckon we've been here?
It's hard to say.
We're gonna be here a lot longer, aren't we?
No, we're not. We're gonna get out of here. Someone has got to open that manhole soon.
Let's face it, Bea, you trusted a pretty crazy hole watcher.
Well, what else could I do? I came down here after you. You were the one that took into your silly bloody head to come racing after the others and not even thinking about it. I wouldn't be down here if it wasn't for you. Yeah. I'm sorry, Bea.
We'll wait for a while. Then we'll try again.
Thanks, Possum.
Security was laughable.
Erica?
Hello, Ted. I'm sorry you've been dragged out on a Sunday.
Yes, well, the lawnmower will have to wait till next week. Now, the minister is really breathing down my neck on this one. He wants a full report.
Yes, well, as I see it, the big deficiency here is staff, both quality and quantity. Discipline is abysmally offhand, and there are very few officers who seem capable of taking any responsibility.
I can agree with your comment on quantity. The amount of overtime my staff is forced to do means that half of them spend more of their time here than they do at home.
I don't think that's what the minister is after. He wants some answers before the opposition make him the scapegoat.
My preliminary investigations indicate a lack of vigilance all around. The actual system of patrols and guards was adequate, but this escape took place right under the noses of these officers.
I suggest we look at the evidence left by the escapees themselves. Those women were driven over the wire.
I wouldn't place too much credence on that document.
Yes, well, what I need is a full outline of the facts. And I suggest you two start working together rather than trying to score points off each other.
Erica Davidson? Yes. I see. Thank you. Another journalist wanting a statement.
Yes, well, I had to wade through a herd of them at the front gate. We'll have to issue a statement, of course. I gather you haven't spoken to them as yet?
Not yet, but if we don't, they'll make up their own story. Mm.
I'll go down and speak to them. The less said, the better. Muckrakers, a lot of them.
No, Erica's the governor. That's her job. You can start work on that report, and I'll see you tomorrow. Erica?
Thank you, Ted, for your support. I'm finding it hard to handle Stuart Gillespie.
I can only support you so far. Now, quite frankly, six women calmly climbing over that fence in broad daylight hardly speaks well for either of you. I try to arbitrate between you and the department, but there's only so much they can take.
Well, they don't understand the problems we face, do they?
Oh, they're going to try, I suggest.
What do you mean?
This inquiry. It could be a royal commission now, you know.
I see.
Mm. And the press are going to have a field day. So let's keep it brief, shall we?
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, not in?
She's out of the gate, talking to the press.
Well, when she comes in, could you tell her that I'm serving the evening meal in the cells? I'll use the usual service.
I'll do no such thing. I ordered that the women be confined to cells, and I meant it. And that includes the trustees. I don't think you fully grasp the situation, Mr. Fletcher.
We need those women to serve the meals.
Well, the alternative's obvious. Have the staff serve the meals.
The staff have worked long enough as it is. Some of them are already over their quotas. I've just let some of them go.
You better catch them. Otherwise, you'll be serving the meal yourself.
Oh, not the sort of day I'd want to repeat in a hurry. It wouldn't be so bad if we didn't have to do double shifts and split shifts. That ridiculous pantomime meant that most of us had no weekend at all.
Well, I'm beginning to forget what my husband looks like.
Well, it's just indulging the prisoners, and we're the ones who suffer.
Ladies, I'm afraid I was a bit premature in letting you go.
Well, we're way past the end of our shift.
Yes, I know that, but Gillespie's ordered that the women are to stay in their cells, which means that we have to serve the meals.
Oh, come on, that's the last straw. What does he think we are, Wonder Women? As far as I'm concerned, he's gone too far this time.
I agree.
Right, the union is going to hear about this one.
If you don't keep quiet.
How long are we going to stay locked up in here, Miss Bennett?
Until we let you out. Now get on with your meal.
I've been thinking. What we're doing is totally against union rules. God, we were fools to accept to do this in the first place. I'm going to ring the union secretary first thing in the morning. If we don't do something about this, we'll end up with sleeping bags on the staff room floor.
What kind of service is this? Mine's bloody cold!
Poor little door. Just one thing after another. Makes you think, doesn't it? Well, just not fair. All that bad luck just for one person.
No.
You reckon it's Monday?
Probably.
Perhaps it's Tuesday. Won't you be?
No. No, thanks.
You're not saying much.
No.
Perhaps you're worried.
Oh, will you cut it out, Lizzie?
Okay. Weren't those little kids terrific? I love being fairy godmother for them. Little eyes shining, all smiles. Makes you feel good, doesn't
Lizzie,
it?
Lizzie, I'm not in the mood, all right?
Oh, come on, Bee. We'll get out of here. We're not going to be stuck down here forever, you know.
I hope you're right.
Of course I'm right. Margo will get us out. No worries. Just a question of time, that's all.
It's time that worries me. I can't stand waiting. I can't stand being stuck. It's driving me crazy. There's nothing I can do. Not a thing. Not a bloody thing.
Yes, I know what you mean.
I'll tell you something else, Lizzie. I blame myself for this whole mess. I should never let you lot think about escaping. It never works. It never has, and it never will.
Feel like a bloody caged animal. Stuck in here. Especially with you two for company. Hey, Phil! See anything out of your window?
Nice moon!
Funny. I mean anything happening.
Nah.
Don't you wish you'd gone too?
Oh, I thought about it.
Who hasn't?
With my luck, I would have been caught with me foot in the drain.
You know, I reckon it all depends on what you do.
How do you mean?
Well, if you get going and just act normally, the cops wouldn't notice you.
Jackie did it.
Till Fletch got the hots for her.
Oh, well, that was just bad luck.
Bad judgment, I reckon.
Night, B, wherever you are.
you lot.
Good night, Fletch.
Where'd you spring from?
Oh, I was asleep in the van.
Fancy cover?
I wouldn't mind.
No worries. Gonna be a great day, eh?
Yes.
Big load in the van, have you?
No. I'm bringing it back.
Been far?
Not too far. Oh, some friends of mine are setting up house away from the city.
Good on them. I like the country. How do you like your tea?
Straight black, thanks.
Yeah, if I had a dough, I'd buy a couple of acres somewhere. Grow me own, know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, I had my own a place once. 10 acres of river flats. Oh, I would have made a bumper spud crop and I'd bingle a rig.
Oh, bad luck.
Yeah. Now what I like about the country, it's the people. City folk are okay, I suppose, but they couldn't give a stuff. They want to know about you. I like the way everybody up here knows you. Nobody's a stranger in the bush.
Nobody?
That's the way it is.
Yeah. See what you mean. Well, listen, thanks for the cargo, but I better get going. I've got to get the van back, see?
Nice talk there. What's your name?
It doesn't matter. See you later.
See ya.
Is the use of a roster if everyone chooses to ignore it.
Good morning, sir.
4 key officers just haven't fronted or even bothered to call. What officer's here on time? One.
Vera Bennett.
What do they think this institution is?
Who's on apart from Vera?
Powell, Watson, Knox and Phillips.
Yeah, well, it's not surprising. They're all on yesterday. Powell was on double shift and the others were on split shift. I can't blame them. I left this place myself 6 hours ago.
When they joined the service, these women knew they'd be expected to work long and hard. You know, if I had my way, all officers would be male.
If you don't watch it, you'll have the union down on us. Union rules stipulate a 10-hour break between shifts. If you push them too hard, they'll simply walk out.
That kind of intimidation is just what the prisoners are after. If they see dissension in the staff, they'll run riot. If the union makes noises over this, it will be completely irresponsible.
Well, I'm just warning you, that's all. Let's have a look at the rosters. Right. Well, Vera's in. Well, I can ask the night shift to extend to cover the gap, and then when the day shift comes in, I'll draw up another roster. That should do us.
It's inefficient and undisciplined.
Yes, well, I better organise the breakfast. I take it I can use the usual trustees while Miss Bennett and I supervise?
No, the order stands. All prisoners are to stay in cells.
We're officers, not waiters. Surely a couple of trustees on the trolleys doesn't constitute a major breakdown in security.
You let me be the judge of that. I was told to tighten security, and I'm going to do it. If it had the cooperation I asked for in the first place, we wouldn't be 6 prisoners short now, would we?
Thank you.
speed limit is 90 kilometres per hour. Didn't you see any signs?
No. No, I didn't. I was in a bit of a state, you know. Tired. I've been travelling a long time.
Well, why didn't you stop?
I guess I panicked.
Let's see your licence. Sandra Bates. Hey, I know you. One of the Wentworth Six.
The officers are already pretty upset about the hours they have to work. This latest business will just make them see red and go to the union. If he keeps up this kind of pressure, they'll just walk out en masse.
Sit down, Jim. Mr. Gillespie is one of the old school. He really believes that discipline and security are the ultimate goals of any prison. We're not going to change his opinion of that. However, there is one bit of good news. The police rang. Heather Trapp has been caught. Have you read today's papers?
No, I haven't.
Well, our girls are heroines, according to that one. We and the police are made to look like fools. You can bet they won't give as much space to the recapture as they gave to the escape.
Yeah, that's for sure. Any other leads?
Not to date, but from past experience, I don't think it'll take long to recapture the others.
Well, it'll be quiet without Smith.
Unnaturally so.
Now, Mrs. Davidson, I hate to harp on it, but what about this confined to cells order?
Well, as this could well be the end of my career as governor of Wentworth, I might as well go out fighting. You have my permission to collect the trustees for serving breakfast.
I'll see to it straight away. And just privately, I don't think you will lose your job over this. This time, I think Gillespie stuck his neck out too far.
Thank you, Jim.
Who's this?
Trapp, one of the escapees.
Oh, you didn't get far, did you? Stand still. I'm talking to you. You can tell me where the others are.
Get stuffed.
Miss Bennett, take her straight to solitary.
She was going there already.
Might make her see things differently, Trapp.
Welcome home, Mouse.
Nice holiday.
Keep quiet, Gaffney, or you'll be joining Trapp in solitary.
Solitary?
Yes.
Well, when you've locked her in, come back and lend a hand. The women are eating their cells this morning.
Again?
Yes, the trustees will serve.
I should hope so. Come on.
Gaffney, outside. You're on trolley duty this morning.
Fresh air. You're a saint, Flitch.
Cut that out, Gaffney, or I'll choose somebody else.
Sorry, bit punchy. Been locked up too long.
Why's this woman out of her cell?
To serve breakfast.
On whose authority?
Governor's orders. Come on, Gaffney.
Julie, no more calls from the press. Tell them to contact the police.
What do you mean by undermining my authority?
Thank you, Julie. You mean serving breakfast?
I gave explicit orders.
When you appeared on our doorstep, we trembled like schoolgirls. We allowed you to destroy a perfectly good working system by introducing methods which alienated both my staff and the prisoners. I ordered the trustees to serve breakfast because with everything else in a shambles, a strike is the last thing we could afford.
You know, Lizzie, I reckon we're going to be in here for good. If they haven't come by now, they're not going to come. And you know something? I don't mind that much. What did I have to look forward to anyway? It's funny, I tried so hard to kill myself before. And it didn't work. I just wanted to stop it all. And it didn't work. It's going to this time. And you know something? I'm ready. I've had enough.
You don't like to think about it, do you? I remember when my old ticker used to play up, I used to be scared that I was gonna die. Then after a while, the fear wore off and... Well, I'm 72 after all. That's long enough.
Glad I'm with you, Lizzie.
Me too. We'll take care of each other.
You know, Kevin won't need a divorce now, because he'll be a widower.
Poor young Kev. He was a nice young man. He loved you, though. I know that.
Yeah, I loved him too.
come to our funeral?
Who?
Mrs. Davidson and them.
Oh, she'll come. So will Mrs. J. But old vinegar tits, she won't. Oh, no, she wouldn't.
She might.
Oh, for Christ's sake, what do you do, Charlotte? We're not going to die in this steaming grave. We are not going to die. We've got to get out of here. We've got to get out. I'm not going to let you die here. Oh, I'm going to get you out. I'm going to get you out. We're not going to die. We're not going to die. We're not going to die. We're not going
to
die.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down, but the sun and rain are prisoners too. Around. Last night I dreamed we were together. Sure.